Hello. Happy Monday, because it is actually Monday today, even though I forgot. So I am here at Good Pie with Mr. Vince Rotolo, and he is actually closed until this all passes over now, but I am here today so he can show you how to make a vegan stromboli at home. So I'm super stoked to bring this to you. And yeah, we're gonna go ahead and turn the camera around and we're gonna watch us make some vegan stromboli. Hello, Mr. Rotolo.
Hi Diana, hi everybody.
Thank you for coming in and showing everybody at home how to do this. Very excited.
Yeah, right, so vegan stromboli. So first of all, stromboli actually started in Philadelphia in like the 1930s and 40s. I was Italian-American immigrants, and stromboli is a type of it's just kind of more of like a, when you roll something up, and it usually contains like meats and cheeses. So the Italian hero, it's like, you know, salami and all the meat stuff that like meat eaters eat. Well, we're the first ones to actually do a vegan stromboli. And what we do is we just, you know, we roll it up, we let it proof. We can do some fun things with it. And the great thing is it's so easy to make. So step one, get pizza dough. Go to your pizzeria, your local pizzeria. I know Metro Pizza's open. They have some of the best dough. So here we have, this is dough from Good Pie. This is a 10-ounce dough ball. It's going to make about a 10 to 12-inch stromboli, depending upon how you roll. So let's just start by how you handle the dough. You're going to pick it up. Normally it's sticky. This one's already kind of been put in some flour. And what you want to do when you have a sticky dough, you want to put it in flour. And then as you kind of work with it, you want to remove the flour. So you want to flour it enough so you can handle it, and then remove the flour because you don't want that floury taste because it can burn easily in your oven, so you don't really want that. So most of the times when you make pizza, you're going to use your hands and you're going to try to push air into the crust. This is completely different, and yes, when you're making pizza, it's usually not acceptable to use a roller, but with stromboli, a dough roller is fine. You can use a wine bottle, you can use anything you have at home. I know Vegan's Baby has plenty of wine bottles around.
I mean, I might have one or two.
Yeah. So what we're doing, we're just going to kind of go in and then out. And then we're going to kind of rotate it over and then back in and out. I'm not the best with one of these. I just kind of go this way. You want to try to get it to be almost like a square shape. And then you can fold it over, right? And you want to kind of go this way and that way. So now we have, it's about 8 inches. And as we build this thing, right, it's gonna continue to get a little bit. So this is pretty much where we wanna be. And then we're gonna kind of roll that way. And what I'm doing here is I'm just kind of cornering it out. I'll corner it out. And you can see the dough is kind of pulling itself back in. Those are the proteins inside the dough that have not relaxed. So if you're working with dough that's really cold and you can't get it to stretch and it keeps shrinking back in on you, just let it sit down in room temperature for another 10 or 15 minutes, let it rest, let the dough relax, and then all of a sudden, you're gonna see it'll be much easier to kind of take shape. All right, so first thing we do is, these can be any ingredients you have around the house, it doesn't matter. We have a vegan cheese here and a vegan Parmesan.
What cheeses are you using?
I'm really not able to discuss the cheeses.
Okay.
It's a proprietary blend.
Okay.
All I can say is it does contain Good Planet.
Okay.
And there's some other cheeses in there that we've blended together. We get here at Good Pie, we get a block of cheese and we shred it ourselves. We find that it melts better. So here I have vegan cheese and vegan parm. I have some tomato, I have artichoke, I have jalapeno, I have banana peppers. We got mushroom, kale, fresh basil. Here we have some other seasonings, right? We have some chili peppers, some dried parsley. This guy started out as fresh parsley. All of our parsley here in the store is fresh, and we pick it and dry it out ourselves because we don't like that old flavor of the dried parsley. This is Greek oregano, incredibly flavorful. Local garlic. We have some sesame seeds here if you really want to get fun. There's some garlic powder. So here's the basic principle. When we're building flavors, whether it's a pizza, whether you're cooking something for the family, whatever dish you're making, I always try to layer flavors that are balancing each other. So salt, acid, fat, heat. And this is the same principle for our stromboli. So let's do this. We're gonna first start with our cheese. And I like to put this in. And if you do our technique, the cheese that we do, this cheese which is going first will be the top, okay? Then what we're gonna do, so now this is a layer of some salt and fat, right? So then we're gonna add in some heat, right? And then I like to add in a little bit of garlic, right? And then let's pick topping. So what's your favorite topping of this? What do you want to pick?
I like artichokes and okay. banana peppers.
So let's do artichoke. So now both of these, because these are in a brine and so are the banana peppers, these are very acidic. So now we have some fat, some acid, and some heat, right? And so what I want to do is add in some basil to kind of like complement that flavor nicely. And then look, a little bit of oregano. All right, and then I like to do three combos, but we can do it either way. So this is banana pepper and that. Now listen, look at this. You see this? Look at this. This is the vegan parm. It's salty. It's really, really delicious. So now we've seasoned it, right? We got some, so look at that. We're gonna open it up a little bit. How about some kale? How about some tomato?
Throw it all in. I just load up on those good veggies.
Let's put some kale in. Some of the kale is gonna be great. It's got, this is garlic roasted kale, but the kale is really, really nice. Okay, so now you have this. Now here's the most difficult part, but it's actually not too difficult. Anybody who ever made a burrito, that's as easy as that. So what we do is, some strombolis, they flavor all the topping and then they roll it up kind of like a Cinnabon. I don't do it that way. It's a little less complicated. So I'm gonna grab here and pull, and then I'm gonna tuck it and just, it's like a burrito.
That's it.
So that's it. It's
rolled. You made it look really easy.
Right. So now the bottom is the top. So now what can we do up here? A lot of people want to add flavor. What I like to do is, here, I have this little knife. And so what I want to do is put some slits in here just to kind of let them breathe a little bit. Okay. And then it'll also help the inside to cook. So now we'll have a little fun with it. Look, I'm going to pour. This is garlic oil.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Okay. So it's really good extra virgin olive oil with some garlic. Okay, and well, you can smell it. And then what we're gonna do is, look, we're gonna sprinkle on top some sesame seeds for some texture and some crunch, you know what I mean? And it does add a nutty flavor. And look, just push the sesame seeds down. So now, what else could we do? I'm gonna put a little bit, just a tiny bit of oregano, just now we can get all, I don't wanna waste this. So I'm gonna get all this stuff here and just put it back on there, on the sides. So for me, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slide this in the oven on a floured board. So I'm gonna take my board, add a little bit of flour, okay? Now some people like to cut the edges off. I just kind of push them in.
Okay.
It depends on what you like. You can do whatever you want, it's your stromboli. There's no need to seal this. So again, I'm gonna quickly put this in the oven. All right, and so right now I'm gonna use this oven right over here. All right, real easy. You slide that guy in, and then that's it. So at home, like I said, if you have a cookie sheet, if you don't have a stone, right, I'm assuming you don't have a stone hearth, you can use any pizza stone. A baking steel is great. If you don't have a baking steel, you should get one. Baking steels are great for making pizzas at home. And also, just any cookie sheet. You can put it on a cookie sheet where you don't have to slide, because sliding it in will take a little bit of practice. And if you don't feel comfortable sliding in it, put it on a pan and just pop it right in the oven. 475 for about 10 to 12 minutes until it starts to brown, okay? So here, let's get this cleaned up a little bit. All right. So while that's baking off, let's talk about our pizzas.
Yes, please.
So this
they're so good.
Is a vegan pizza here. And one of the great things, you know, a lot of you guys know we've been working towards opening our new pizza bar on Main Street. So many more vegan options. There'll always be vegan strombolis available in the window. We're gonna have these vegan panzerotti, which are like a kind of a fried calzone. We're gonna have a special fryer oil that only vegan products are in. So when we fry the panzerotti or we do these other fried items like the fried artichokes and some other the just little nibblers at the bar. But the cool thing is that we're gonna have a full bar.
Yes.
So all the best, and you know, a lot of people, I learned recently there is vegan and non-vegan wine. I didn't know that. I thought all wine was vegan, but I've learned recently through Vegan's Baby and some of my other vegan friends, there is, you know, vegan wine and vegan beer and vegan spirits, and it's really going to be a fantastic bar where the Good Pie experience will now be fully realized. So guys, please follow us on social media, Good Pie LV on Instagram or Good Pie LV on Facebook. So big news, I always like to make a special announcement when I got vegan baby in the house. So on Main Street, so many people come in and they, when we don't have slices in the window and they want something, we are now going to be offering vegan 12-inch pizzas at Main Street.
Yeah.
All right? These babies start at $12. It's a 12-inch pizza. This pizza here was just baked in our deck oven. And let me give you guys a hint. I know people like to pile tons of toppings on, but tons of toppings are not good. Really, what we want to do is this. Listen carefully. Try, especially making pizza at home, try to do your two-topping combo. And think about that salt, fat, acid, heat, sweet, balance of flavor. So this is caramelized onion, which are really, really sweet, and local mushrooms that are roasted in garlic and oil and some thyme, which are really earthy. So the sweet, earthy balance along with our cheese and the acid of the tomato sauce. There's garlic on here. There's some of these chilies. Some of the chilies are on here. And again, guys, less is more, and you're building layers of flavor. Remember that. So try to, before you start getting into these toppings of everything you want, stick to the basic, like these two topping combos. So here, let me get our vegan cutter. Cut it right back. I have a pizza cutter here. So look, this guy, here's my vegan cutter. All right. So what we do is we use the white handle as vegan, okay? And the black handle is regular. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get into this pizza. Oh man, I'm gonna do this in six slices. Oh, look at this. Oh my goodness, and just push that guy down at the end. So this has been sitting here for a minute, but I just wanna kinda, look at this. And so really, here, I'll do this. To pull that apart. And so look, here's what we're looking for in a pizza, right? You want to see that there's air in the crust, nice and airy. You want to be able to fold it together. And look, it has a little bit of drip, but look at the bottom, how caramelized it is. Nice, delicious, here, wait. Mmm.
It's like a crunch.
I mean, kind of want to make me go vegan. I mean, it's really, really good.
It's never a bad idea.
So, all right. So while that's cooking, let's pretend time has gone by. All right. And then bam, here's what it's going to come out looking like. Right. So check it out. You see the cheese peeking through the golden brown color, and you're looking for the blistering. You guys stay on it. My recommendation is to use a bread knife. Okay, and you want to cut it at an angle. You can do it in three pieces, like that. Let it cool a little bit, okay? Treat it like a steak. Let it cool.
They're vegan.
I'm kidding. That was a joke I tried to slip in there. You know I love you guys. Let your stromboli rest.
Okay.
So it doesn't fall all over the place. So look at the inside of this guy. You can see it's got the... And this is mushroom kale with the caramelized onion, banana pepper, and just take a look. So it's like a sandwich. Now, here's what's great about these. These guys can be individually wrapped and frozen for up to 30 days. So it's great. You can wrap it once it cools. You can freeze it. And here, check it out. What we're going to do is we're going to take some of this.
And
look, sauce. All right. Parsley. Okay, look, you can even drizzle some oil on top at the end and then season it a little bit. You could do that, right? Check this out. Look here. That, guys. And so here, when you want to eat this thing, you could take this, right? Take it. When we sell ours, we sell it with a side of sauce, a 4-ounce side of its organic tomatoes. We use Chow Tomato Import from Italy. It's the best tomato we can buy. So you can find Chow in a lot of your good high-quality markets, but... really, any good quality tomato, I only buy organic, the best quality. And what you want to do is you take it, right? You dip it in. Look, you dip that in like that, and then you just kind of...
No, you do it.
You want...
Eat it. And I'm just going to say really quick, if you've never had the sauce that Vince makes here at Good Pie,
no.
Try it. It's my favorite in town. Probably my favorite in the world.
Oh my goodness. Guys, vegan Stromboli.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so. Question for you, really quick.
Yeah.
If you're, you know, if you're doing Instacart or something, and you're going to use like a, just a store bought cheese, what store bought cheese would you suggest? What do you think melts the best in terms of like Dia, Violife, all those?
I've used a lot. Yep. You know, my favorite is New Moo. They're very hard to get.
Yep.
I think for you, you have to play with cheeses and see what works for you guys.
Mm-hmm.
I've tested cheeses at all different degrees, different temperatures, 850, 600, 700, 5, 4. I've tested them. I've had vegans over the house, and it's fun, right? So
yeah.
My advice is buy 3 or 4 cheeses. Use them in different applications or the same application and see what works for you. And you may discover a new combination and share your secrets with me, because I'm constantly looking for something new. What I was doing a year ago, I'm not doing now. What I was doing 6 months ago, I'm not doing now. What we're going to do on Main Street is going to be better. And that's the whole thing. We're elevating food, but at the same time, we're honoring tradition. But we don't have to be stuck in tradition. We can have our own perspective from our generation. And our generation is more vegans and we're more aware. And so you can still honor your family recipes and, you know, veganize them and make them delicious. And it's okay. Like, I do that at home. I try to eat healthy more and more. The more I learn, the more vegan that I eat. And so it's really about a learning process. But right now, you know, my favorite cheeses are not available to the public, and that's the truth.
Yeah.
I'm only using a commercial product that is very difficult to get, and that...
Very, you know, very good.
I'm trying to put the best out here, and guess what? In 3 months, it'll be different.
Yeah.
So the great thing about us is we keep pushing the envelope. We keep going on and on and on. But this... I mean, I'm not saying this just because Vegan Baby's here, but this is the best Stromboli I've ever made. So, yeah, check us out. We're going to post the recipe, and next time... We're going to actually go through our dough-making process with you at home. But for now, just go buy pizza dough and practice. And when you're ready to start making, you know, your own dough that is good, you can use it for pizza, right? But you can also use it for Stromboli. You can use it for calzones. You can actually make your own bread. You can fry it, and you can wrap it in, you know, pigs in a blanket, whatever you want to do, like vegan pigs in a blanket.
Yeah.
No, because one of the things we don't do, and I want to be very clear, we've tried every kind of vegan meat that's out on the market, and I don't use any of them. My favorite vegan meat is a mushroom.
Yes.
And that's just me personally. And I'm not saying anyone can't have a vegan sausage or a vegan meatball or a vegan whatever, but when I started to research the ingredients of what they put in these, like, synthetic meat products, it made me uncomfortable, so I decided I'm only going to serve vegetables and make them taste delicious. And it's a choice that I made. But you can do your own thing, and, you know, there's no right or wrong. It's just exploring and having fun. And that's what I can encourage everybody to do. Get out here, try the recipe, have fun, explore it, and all of a sudden, you're going to have the most delicious home meals that you can.
Let's take one more little look at this Stromboli and that beautiful sauce.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir, for joining us today.
Thank you guys for checking this out, and I'm going to get
that. Eat it. We'll have the recipe on vegansbaby.com really soon. Have a great day, you guys. Be safe. Be well.